Hello, I'm Corey Champ. Today I will be highlighting the density circulation apparatus used with Passport probeware and SparkView software. The density circulation apparatus is new to PASCO, and today I will highlight its use in an earth science application modeling a thermocline. The apparatus is 2 1-liter plexiglass containers connected by 2 flow valves, which allow water to flow between the chambers. Today's activity comes from the user's manual, which is supplied with the apparatus. The manual offers this and other experiments to accompany the apparatus. To perform this activity, we start with 2 water bodies of different densities. In this case, the density difference is driven by temperature. We could also use salinity or both temperature and salinity. I've added food coloring to help differentiate the waters and to help see what happens when they mix. And now the second water. Okay. Now I've pre-configured the software to save some time, and I'll be taking manual samples at 1 centimeter intervals along the markings on the side of the tank. First, I plug in my temperature sensor and push start to begin sampling. Initially, I'm just going to show you the difference in temperature between the 2 chambers. And it's just about stabilized. And now let's check the other chamber. So there's clearly a difference in temperature between these 2 water bodies. Okay, now I'm going to open the valves and let the water interact. I'll start with the upper chamber. And now the lower chamber. Make sure to focus in on looking at the bottom of the chamber as the water interacts. You can see that there's a smooth continuous flow as the water bodies interact, and this is true even for very small density differences. Okay, looks like they have finished mixing, and now we want to model our thermocline. As I mentioned before, the software was pre-configured to save time, and as you can see, I have a table set up with depth in 1 column and temperature in the 2nd column. So I'm going to start collecting data. First data point. And then 2nd data point. Okay, and we've collected all 20 data points. So I'm going to stop the data collection. And now to look at the data, I'm going to build a page. We're going to plot depth on the y-axis and temperature on the x-axis. And you can see that we have our idealized thermocline. I'm going to scale to fit to make sure that the data is fitting the screen completely. And a thermocline is defined as a rapid temperature over a very small depth. And you can see that our thermocline does show that. We had a very, very rapid temperature change on the order of 15 degrees in this very, very small space. This is exactly what we'd expect to see in an idealized thermocline. As I mentioned before, this experiment could be performed with salt and temperature using PASCO's salinity sensor. So you could also use salinity to define the density differences. There are many other experiments students can perform with the density circulation apparatus, including convection and temperature inversions. This completes the experiment. We hope you've enjoyed the demonstration.